Today I'll be having a look at the ever-shrinking spinning mechanical hard disk. And I'm starting with the 3.5-inch size. If you're around in the mid-80s and you saw this get invented after the 1960s and 1970s sizes, you would have thought, well, that's tiny. But we're actually going to be using this as a reference for the smaller ones. Right at the end of the 1980s, a new size was developed that caught on. The 2.5-inch, as you can see, it's really quite a bit smaller. The 2.5 still lives on today. The interface got updated with serial ATA. And then when SSDs came out, they continued the 2.5-inch size. All right, next size comparison is the 2.5 to... So at some point in the 1990s was the 1.8-inch hard disk. We've got one here. These drives first became highly popular when Apple decided to use one to manufacture their iPods. So the form factor of the iPod was in part determined by the size of the 1.8-inch spinning hard disk. And Apple continued to use spinning hard disks for quite a while. I have another one here. This is another 1.8-inch, but we can see we've got a different connector on it. And Apple continued to use these drives for many generations. Here we have another Apple one. This is a 18 gigabyte. It's unusual to see a product with both the Samsung logo and the Apple logo on at the same time, but there you go. And once again, when solid state drives came out, they kept the 1.8-inch spinning disk size mentioned on the outside. And so there's the ZIF connector. Okay, so we're going to move these two out of the picture. As far as I'm aware, all of these other drives here are fully functional. But the Samsung Apple drive is faulty. The bearings sound terrible and it won't read or write any data, which means I can take it apart and have a look at the mechanism and then power it up with the mechanism open and have a look. Okay, it's coming apart. It does have a bit of a rubber seal around it. And a hidden screw. Alright, well, let's try removing this. See if that helps. There it is. One hidden screw. And we have the inside. So we've got the mechanism open. Now I want to power this up. And to power this up, I'm going to use the interface mechanism from a 1.8-inch hard drive external caddy. Okay. So we're just going to find that connector and use a lot of force to get this zero insertion force connector in. We've got to push hard. Okay, that's in. Close the door. Okay, we've got our interface connected. And I've got a mini USB plugged into a computer at the other end. We've got power. And nothing else. Let's have a poke around. Okay, well, we can see the actuator arm. It's moving the heads across the disk and trying to read something. Okay, that's the mechanism powered off. I'm going to put this back together for now, just with that one screw. So for comparison, we will have this Samsung Apple drive here, and we'll move to the next size down, which is reasonably well known, and that's the 1-inch Microdrive. And there we have an Apple logo, so this gives away where this came from. So when Apple wanted to shrink their iPod down even further, and they made the iPod mini, which is a bit smaller, and this one's been taken apart already. So here we have an iPod mini internals, and there we can see where Apple fitted the Microdrive. And what's interesting about this format is that it is basically a compact flash card. So compact flash originally started as a flash memory format, and then later it moved into the mechanical spinning format, which if you had one of these iPod minis, you could simply buy a compact flash card and replace the spinning hard drive with flash memory. As well as being used inside consumer products, you could actually buy these drives to use, maybe fit inside your digital camera. There's a retail version there. I've got a Hitachi 4GB, which this is out of an iPod as well. So these three little drives are all functional still, so I'm going to put them aside. And I've got this one here, and this is a faulty Microdrive, and it doesn't have the Apple logo on it, so it means it's not out of an iPod. It does spin, but it doesn't work. So this one I can take apart and have a look at that mechanism. Okay, I found a tri-wing, so let's get this open. Okay, it looks like we may be on the wrong side. I have revealed the controller board. And okay, here we have the mechanism. Okay, I can see a gap into the mechanism now, so it looks like it's now open to the elements. So this sticker was part of the seal that I'm peeling off now. We've got four more screws for this plate on top. Okay, is this it? Yeah, that looks pretty good. That's pretty small. So I do want to see if I can power this up, which means attaching it to here and putting it into a compact flash card reader, which I just happen to have one handy. And that was the Microdrive, the second smallest hard drive ever made. And if we compare it to a full-size SD card, we can see it is really quite a small drive. But it's not the smallest. There is a smaller one. And we're going to have a look at one of those today. I have here the Nokia N91 mobile phone. This is from 2004. And this has a hard drive inside of it. Back then, flash memory like SD cards were, if you had a 128 meg, that was pretty big. And I think 512 meg, they're available and you had to pay quite a bit. But Nokia decided to go for, I'm going to power this up and we can have a listen to it and see how it works. Standard Nokia power up coming in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, let's test the music. Make sure it plays okay. Okay, so we know the hard disk in this phone does still work, so let's power off. And let's have a look at the disk unit itself. Okay, there's really just those six screws holding this phone together. So this was manufactured back in the days when things were meant to be taken apart and actually fixed. And there was no need to glue everything together. Okay, we've got our Nokia open. And we're inside. We've got our main board, and here is the hard drive. So let's pop this out. Bracket holding that in. That plate can come out. There we go. And we have a bit of a rubbery surround. And there we go, there it is. So let's get this microdrive here. And this is a 0.85 inch platter. And I have here another one. And this is the same drive, but out of a different phone. And what I can tell you is that both of these drives work, because I have pre-tested this drive in this phone. So both of these drives work, which means no taking this mechanism apart. We can see the label, it's a Toshiba, it's a 4 GB. And this phone was re-released later in... Okay, so it was released in 2004, and then I think in 2005 they released the 8 GB version. So these drives were available in up to 8 GB, as were the micro drives. So the size of this hard disk is pretty similar to a full-size SD card, but a lot fatter. Now this interface in on here is actually, in theory, a usable interface. So let's go and have a look at the predecessor to the SD card, which is the MMC card. And here's the SD card which replaced it. And SD cards are just a little bit fatter. And there's a bit of a ridge on the pins, whereas MMC is pretty flat. It has less pins than SD. MMC cards split in two different directions. One direction went towards SD, and then eventually micro SD. And the other direction was they developed MMC Plus, which maybe you can see what's going on here. The interface on these micro hard drives is MMC Plus. MMC is still in use today as eMMC, which is embedded MMC, so all our phones and the gigabytes that we carry around embedded in our phones is all based on this original MMC standard. Now, I've tried to read these drives using SD card readers, but I can't get them to spin up. So that's going to have to be a project for another time. One thing I am wondering though, is it possible to put one of these MMC cards into this phone and have it recognize it? Okay, we've got our half-height MMC Plus card. I think it's lined up enough to reach those pins. Okay, let's power up this phone now and see what happens. I have found on a Polish forum a photograph inside one of these drives, so I'm going to show that to you now and link to the forum below, just in case you read Polish and want to be able to find out more about that particular post where I pilfered this image from. Music library details tell me that -632 GB is used, and the available is infinite gigabytes. So I don't think that card is actually working. And you can bet if I can ever get this interface working, that I'll be making the world's smallest mechanical spinning hard disk USB memory stick. To finish up, I'm going to do a comparison of the platter size between the 3.5 inch, the 1.8 inch, the 1 inch and 0.85 inch. If you're using a laptop at the time this video was made, it's very unlikely you've got a spinning disc inside it. If you've got a desktop, maybe you've got a spinning disc. But if you've got data in the cloud, even years from after when this video is made, it's very, very likely all your data is on one of these. Certainly all these YouTube videos are coming off exactly this sort of platter. Okay, that's it. We're done.